Today, we are sharing a new Town Hall 8-based design with you. If you are new here, consider subscribing, because we bring you great base design for every Town Hall level. And we will also explain why certain buildings are placed in certain places while doing speed build. Also, we will show the effective range of every defensive building, and some defense replays later in this video. So, let's talk about the base design while doing speed build. This base is designed to protect both trophies and loot. Since Town Hall is the important building because the opponent can get one star from destroying it, and it stores some loot in it. So, it is placed in the center of the base, where all the defensive buildings can guard it. And we also know that the Dark Elixir is also hard to collect, so Dark Elixir storage is placed in the inner compartment of the base where opponent cannot reach it easily. And all the air defenses, wizard towers and bomb towers are placed around the main compartment, because these defensive buildings can deal more damage than other defensive buildings. So it can protect core part of the base during the raids, so that the opponent cannot get 2 or 3 stars from this base. Since these defensive buildings are in the inner compartments of the base, opponents cannot reach it easily, so it can defend base for much longer. Also, all the air defense and air sweeper are placed far from one another, so that the lightning spells cannot take both at same time. And Dark Elixir storage is also guarded with these defensive buildings along with Barbarian King and Tesla Farm. Also, all the mortars are distributed in such a way that it can cover whole base, and defend base from spamming troops such as barbarians and archers. And, we need loot for upgrading troop heroes and buildings. So, we need to protect storage buildings from the opponent. That's why we need to consider storage building placement while making the base. If we placed all the storage buildings in the same compartment in the inner part of the base, it may protect loot for a few raids, but if the opponent reaches that particular compartment, they can steal all the loot. That's why all the storage buildings are placed far from each other into different compartments, so that opponents can't get all the loot just by entering one compartment. In order to get all the loot, they need to destroy the space. And these storage buildings are guarded with all the defensive structures. Since the core of the base is heavily guarded with the main defensive structures, we also need to secure the edge of the base, which will make it hard for the opponent on their funneling process. So all archer towers and cannons are placed on the edge of the base, so it can cover those areas to defend against air and ground troops. And all the traps are placed in the area where they can work effectively, such as giant bombs are placed in the area where it can work against hog riders and giants. Air bombs and air mines are placed near to the wizard towers and air defense to back up to these buildings, and skeleton traps are placed near the town hall, so it can distract opponents' troops while they reach near to the town hall. Once again, let's see the placement of the defensive structures and heroes, and its effective coverage. Let's see some defense replays, so that you can know how effective this base is. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, hit that like button and share it with your friends. And if you are not subscribed to our channel yet, then hit that red subscribe button and turn on the notification bell. And if you need more base layout at different town hall levels, make sure to mention in the comment section. And I will see you in the next one.
Run free, so I drown them out at night with my TV. You know we got to try to ignore these thoughts that go back and forth inside my head. I should stop before I